Greetings of the day. Welcome to another session of Grade 9 Mathematics. Chapter 6, Lines and Angles. Dear students, in this very first part of the chapter, we learn different concepts associated with lines and angles and also understand and recall the different pair of angles also studied in the previous grades. Let's quickly get to the explanation part.
So, let us begin with some important concepts that are essential to solve the sums of chapter 6, lines and angles. Now, the very first concept that I wish to discuss over here is about something called linear pair of angles. Now, what are linear pair of angles? Now, this is not something that has come to us for the very first time. Yes, we have come across linear pair of angles in grade 8 as well as 7. But then let's quickly discuss this. Now, say I have got a figure which looks something like this. Okay, so this is a line and I have another ray. Yeah, so this ray and this line has got a common point. Now, let me name them. This is A, line AB, and say this is line, this is point C, and this is say D. Okay, now in this given figure, if you could observe, there are two angles that are formed. One of them is this, which is, how do you call this angle? You can call it angle ABC. Yeah, let me write this over here, A, B, C, and there is another angle that gets formed over here, which is this one. We can call it angle B, B, C. Now, I am going to say that these angles are linear pair of angles. I say it again, these angles are linear pair of angles. Now the question is, how can I just simply take two angles that are formed in this figure and just call them linear pair of angles? There has to be some reason behind it. Yes, there is a reason when I call a pair of angles as linear pair. The first thing that I have to look forward is, two angles can be called a linear pair of angles if it has got a common vertex. If it has got a common vertex. Now, if you could look into angle ABC and angle BDC, it has got a common vertex. Okay? Now, the second thing that a linear pair of angles should have is a common arm. What is supposed to have? A common arm. Now, what is a common arm over here? If you look at angle ADC, for angle ADC, the arms are AD and DC. For angle BDC, the arms are BD and DC. But then if you compare these two angles, it has got a common arm. And what is that common arm? DC. So, the second condition for an angle to be linear pair of angle is it has to have a common arm. And the third condition is the uncommon arm. That is, the arm that is not common should be on opposite side of common arm. So the uncommon arm, whatever it is. Now in this case, for these angles, what are the uncommon arms? AD and BD. They are not common to both angles. Yeah. So it's the uncommon arm. Now if you could see these uncommon arms, they are on the opposite sides of the common arm. So when these three conditions get fulfilled, I can call the two angles as linear pair of angles. I say it again, only when these three conditions, what are the conditions? It has to have a common vertex, it has to have a common arm, and the third condition is the uncommon arm should be on the opposite sides of the common arm. If these three conditions get fulfilled, I can call these two angles as linear pair of angles. Now, the linear pair of angles, okay, I say it again, the linear pair of angles would always sum up to be 180 degrees. That is, the linear pair of angles will always be 180 degrees, because if you could observe here, this is a straight line and the straight angle has to be 180 degrees. Yeah, so the straight angle is divided into two, which we are right now calling as the linear pair of angles. Yes, so the linear pair of angles should always be 180. The sum should always be 180. So if these are my linear angles, I would write angle ADC plus, because the sum has to be 180. So plus the next angle, which is BDC, which are my linear pair of angles, is equal to 180 degrees. I hope this is clear. If this is clear, then let's get to the next concept. Now, as you could see, the next concept that I wish to discuss with you all is about pair of angles. Before we actually get into the understanding of pair of angles, I would like you to introduce to something called parallel lines. Okay? So what are parallel lines? Parallel lines are those lines wherein the distance between them remains the same at any point, and they never intersect with each other. So let me say this is line L, and this is line M. So L and M are my parallel lines. Now, if I have another line which passes through these parallel lines, that is L and M. I say it again. Say if I have another line, something of this sort, yes, which passes through line L and line M. Let me call this line to be line P. Okay. Now, what is P? P is a line which is passing through L and M. And what are my L and M? My L and M are parallel lines. Now, this line P, which passes through my parallel lines, will be called a transversal. What will this line be called? A transversal. So what is a transversal? A transversal is a line that passes through two or more than two parallel lines. I hope this is clear. But at the same time, you shall observe over here that this transversal passing through the parallel lines leads to the formation of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 angles. If you could see, when this transversal actually passed through these two parallel lines, it actually led to the formation of 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 angles. Now let me number them for your sake of understanding. So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this one is 5, yeah, let's say this is 6, this is 7, this is 8. Okay, I just randomly numbered it, you could have numbered it anyways. So how many angles are there? 8 angles. Now if I try to find the pair of angles, yeah, the first pair that I shall get is something called, I've already discussed, the linear pair of angles. What are the first pair that we shall be discussing? The linear pair of angles. Now, if you have understood what are the linear pairs, tell me which one were the linear pairs over here. Angle 1 and angle 2. If you look at the slantway, even angle 1 and angle 4. Angle 2, if you look at this way, angle 2 and angle 3. angle 5 and angle 6. Angle 5 forms a linear pair also with angle 8. 8 forms a linear pair with 7. And 7 also forms a linear pair with 6. So 6 forms a linear pair with 5, as well as 6 forms a linear pair with 7. So just note down the linear pairs, angle 1 and angle 2, angle 2 and angle 3, angle 3 and angle 4, yes, angle 4 and angle 1. Likewise, if I go with these angles, angle 5 and angle 6, angle 6 and angle 7, angle 7 and angle 8, and then I have angle 5 and angle 8. So these are the linear pair of angles, and we have already learned that the linear pair of angles would always sum up to be 180 degrees. So what does that mean? If 1 and 2 are linear pairs, the sum of these two angles will be 180. Likewise, if 1 and 4 are linear pair of angles, their sum would be 180 degrees. The same is for angle 6 and angle 7 also, angle 5 and angle 6 also, yeah, or say angle 8 and angle 7 also. They all would sum up to be 180 degrees. Apart from that, the next type of angle that you should be aware of is something called the corresponding pair of angles. Now this is important. Now, how many parallel lines have you got? You have got a pair of parallel lines. The first among them is L and the other one is M. Now, how to look at and find what are the corresponding angles? Now, if you look at the right side of the transversal, so this is a transversal, right? The right side of the transversal, what are the angles present? Angle 2, angle 3, angle 6, and angle 7. In that, if you find which are the angles above the lines, over here it is angle 2 and over here it is angle 6. So angle 2 and angle 6 makes a pair. Okay, now if I go below the line, then angle 3 and angle 7 makes a pair. If I go to the left side, which are the ones? Angle 1 and angle 5. And if I go below the line, it is angle 4 and angle 8. Okay, so these ones are called the corresponding pair of angles. And my dear students, the corresponding pair of angles are always equal. What are they? They are always equal. What does that mean? If angle 2 is 60 degree, angle 6 will also be 60 degree. If angle 4 is say 110 degree, angle 8 will also be 110 degree. So that means if angle 4 is 110 degree, angle 8 will also be 110 degree. So what is the second pair of angles that you have learned? Something called the corresponding pair of angles. And the corresponding pair of angles are always equal. Now let me take you to another set of angles, which are called the vertically opposite angles. What are they called? Vertically opposite angles. Now, as the name itself suggests, they are opposite angles. Opposite to what? To the vertex. Now, where is the vertex over in this figure? This is a vertex. So I've got one vertex over here and I've got another vertex over here. So if, as I go by the name, vertically opposite angles. So if I look at this vertex, which are the opposite angles? Angle 2 and angle 4. Angle 2 and angle 4. Likewise for this vertex, angle 1 and angle 3 is also opposite angle. So angle 1 and angle 3 also. Also, if you go by this vertex, which are the opposite angles? Angle 5 and angle 7, and then also angle 6 and angle 8. So I'll write that angle 5 and angle 7 and angle 6 and angle 8. Now the fact is that the vertically opposite angles are also always equal. Vertically opposite angles are also always equal. So that means if angle 2 is 80 degree, angle 4 will also be 80 degree, because the vertically opposite angles are always equal. If angle, say 5 is 150 degree, then angle 7 will also be 150 degree. We shall try to understand them in detail by solving a few questions later. But for the time being, which are the three type of angles that we have discussed? The linear pair of angles, the corresponding pair of angles, and the vertically opposite angles. Now let us get into the next type of angle. Now, the next type of angle that I want you guys to be aware of is something called interior alternate angles. So what is it? Interior alternate angles. Okay. Now, it's pretty clear from the statement, the name itself. It has to be interior. It has to be alternate angles. Now, let us find the angles which are interior. Now, if you have got these lines, the angles between these lines are called the interior angles, because that is the interior region. Okay? And if you could see, the region above the line L will be called the exterior region. Likewise, the region below line M will be also known as exterior region. So the interior region would have interior angles, and the exterior regions would have exterior angles. Which are the angles that we are concerned right now? The interior angles. So which are the interior angles in this region? So angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, and angle 6. But then, do I just need interior angles? No, I need them to be interior as well as alternate. So which are the interior alternate angles? They have to be interior as well as alternate. So angle 3 and angle 5, see, they are alternate. And likewise, angle 4 and angle 6. So they have to be interior and they have to be alternate. So angle 3 and angle 5, angle 4, and angle 6. So what are they known as? Interior alternate angles. And my dear students, the interior alternate angles are also always equal. They are also always equal. Okay. Now, can you help me find out what are the exterior alternate angles? Yes, the next one is exterior alternate angles. So, as we did in the previous case, let's go by the name. It has to be exterior, it has to be alternate. So, which are my exterior angles? If I just put my finger over here, which are the exterior angles? Angle 1 and 2 and angle 8 and 7. Yeah, as you could see in the screen, which are my exterior angles? 1 and 2, because that is part of the exterior region. And over here, the exterior region is this, and I have angles 7 and 8. But then, do I just need exterior angles? No, I need exterior alternate angles. So how would I go by? 1 and 7, 2 and 8. So I'll write angle 1 and angle 7, angle 2 and angle 8. And as it is in the case of interior alternate angles, the exterior alternate angles are also always equal to one another. So that means if angle 1 is 120 degree, the exterior opposite angle to that is angle 7 will also be 120 degree. Or say angle 2 is 60 degree, the exterior opposite to that is angle 8 will also be 60 degree. So this is about exterior alternate angles. Now, the next type of angle that I want to discuss with you guys is something called interior angles on the same side of transversal. Okay, so what is the next type of angle that we are going to learn? Is something called interior angles on the same side of transversal. So very clear from the name itself, they have to be interior angles, and then they have to be on the same side of the transversal. So which are my interior angles, by the way? Angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6. But more importantly, what do I need? They have to be interior but on the same side of transversal. Okay, so which are the angles on the same side of transversal but as well as interior? Interior have 3, 4, 5, 6, but on the same side of the transversal, here I have 3 and 6, and on the other same side I have 4 and 5. So I'll write here angle 3 and angle 6, and then angle 4 and angle 5. My dear students, interior angles on the same side of transversal always sum up to be 180 degrees. So what is the sum? 180 degrees. So what does that mean? Angle 3 plus angle 6 would always sum up to be 180 degrees. Likewise, angle 4 plus angle 5 would always sum up to be 180 degrees. I hope this is clear to you all. So as of now, we have discussed different pair of angles. So the first pair of angles that we have discussed was linear pair of angles. Then we discussed what is corresponding pair of angles. Then we went on to discuss vertically opposite angles. Then interior alternate angles, exterior alternate angles, and now we have discussed what are the interior angles on the same side of transversal. Dear students, the next concept that I wish to discuss is something called the exterior angle property for triangles. Now to understand this, let me draw a diagram. Let me draw a triangle to begin with. Say this is an triangle with angle A, B and C. See, when I call angle A, B and C, I am referring to the interior angle A, interior angle B and interior angle C. Okay, now say I am actually producing BC, I'm extending BC. Okay, say I've extended BC and let me name it, like let's say this point to be D. Okay, now when this happened, it led to the formation of another angle also, but that is outside the triangle, not the interior region of the triangle but the exterior region of that triangle. So which is the angle that is formed in the exterior region? Angle A, C, D. Angle A, C, D. Now the exterior angle property of triangle says that if in a triangle you have got an exterior angle, that exterior angle, that is angle ACD over here, would be equal to the sum, that is addition, the sum of two opposite interior angles. Okay, sum of two. So there are two angles, but how are those two angles? Two opposite interior angles. So they have to be interior, but then they have to be opposite also. So if I consider this is my exterior angle, these two, angle A and this angle B, would become my interior opposite angles. So if I go by the statement of exterior angle property, the exterior angle ACD will be equal to the sum of angle BAC plus angle ABC. Okay, so if you are saying that this is 50 degree and this is 60 degree, what would this angle be? Very easy. The exterior angle would be sum of two opposite interior angles. It has to be opposite, okay, opposite to the exterior angle, and it has to be interior. So I can say this is 60, this is 50. I add them up, yeah, and I will get my exterior angle. Say in this case it would be 110 degree. I hope now we're clear with the exterior angle property of triangles also. My dear students, with this we come to the end of this session, wherein we have learned some important concepts for the chapter 6, lines and angles. Kindly learn and revise these concepts thoroughly so that you can solve the NCERT exercises 6.1, 6.2 and 6.3 along with me in the next session. Take care of yourself until we meet next time with another session. Thank you.